Well, hello everybody, welcome, I'm Davey. Today I'm sharing with you a pregnancy update video. I have not done one for this second baby at all yet, and I'm over halfway through my pregnancy with my first daughter. We did updates, every so often, for sure every trimester, but I just thought it would be fun to share what's been happening, what's been going on this pregnancy, and some of you I know are interested. If you're not interested in this type of video, you can go back to my normal content or skip this one, because next week I'll be doing more of my homemaking, simple living videos, and that type of content. But anyways, I'm just gonna share with you what's been going on this pregnancy and also our gender reveal. All right, so first trimester, we actually did a home pregnancy test to find out we were pregnant at 4 weeks along, which is super early for me, because with our first daughter, I didn't start feeling sick or realizing it until I was about 8 weeks. That being said, I never ended up getting my cycle back after having nursed our first daughter up till about 16, 17 months old. And my cycle's always been a variation of 28 days to 60 days. So I'm very inconsistent in that way. So that is part of why we didn't really know, but I kind of felt something was going on, as yes, we had been trying, and yes, I was feeling sick at about 4 weeks along, which is so early for me. We did go find out for sure in an ultrasound at about 9 weeks along, just to make sure and see the little one. And I was really quite sick up until about 12 weeks along, so a little bit before the second trimester started. And I really think part of that I have to attest to my prenatal. I started this prenatal. I love it. I'll link it in the description box. I get it from Vitacost. It's an all-natural supplement. It also has some ginger in it. It has folate instead of folic acid in it. I just think that really helped me feel better, especially having that ginger. So I did start to be on the uphill side of the sickness at about 12, 13 weeks, which was such a blessing. I was quite sick and quite tired, as a lot of you who are pregnant have experienced before. I never did have to vomit or throw up, thank the Lord, but my nausea started about 2 p.m. till I went to bed, and we put Nevaeh down, our 1.5-year-old, at about 7:15, 7:30, and about half hour later I was in bed because I just was not feeling well. And I did not enjoy food really at all. In the morning was fine. I didn't have morning sickness, as you can tell. It was more of day sickness. And I know that happens to quite a few pregnant women, where the morning they're actually okay, and then it's more of the afternoon, evening time. And so I did not gain any weight in the first trimester, which is totally normal, totally okay. And if you do gain weight in the first trimester, that is okay too, but I just never did because I just did not feel like eating much. I tried to just make sure I was eating enough to keep my stomach soothed, and I was relatively cautious with what I ate, but if pizza from Aldi sounded great, that's what we had that night. Or if I wanted a slice of bread, that is what I had. So I really just tried to supplement my body with foods that sounded good at the time. Let's see, didn't really have much for cravings. More salty, actually, I guess. So like, I would like my tortilla chips and salsa because I love those anyways, but I just, that was really good. Pretzels, definitely did not like peanut butter. I love peanut butter normally, but did not like that. Did not like ice cream, and I normally like ice cream. You know, so just those typical things that people enjoy, I really did not enjoy. So then after I reached the second trimester, about 13, 14 weeks, my energy levels lifted. I was not as sick, still a little tired, but getting much more energy. And I just praise the Lord that my sickness did not run into the second trimester, as I've seen some YouTubers. One of my good friends has been sick up to like 22, 23 weeks. And I just feel very blessed that I did not have that sickness as much. And then I've also been reading to help with pregnancy, rereading I should say, this Mama Natural book. As you can tell, I've marked a lot of things and pages on here. This is a super helpful book. It was for me for the first pregnancy. And so I'm just touching on what's been going on in each week of the pregnancy. And I really like this book as well. I'll link that in the description box for you as well if you're interested, because I would love to have a natural labor. I was planning that for that with Nevaeh, our first, and ended up having to be induced as I was 41 weeks and Nevaeh was at risk in the womb, so we just had to do that. So I would love to have a natural labor, but you know, I know the safety of the mom and the baby is the most important. So that's been a good book. And then I also was recommended by a friend the book called Holy Labor, and I'm just about probably like a sixth of the way in, and some of it's very difficult to read, but it just gives a really good perspective on the Bible and childbearing and a biblical perspective on giving birth. And honestly, I think it's almost better for a second time mom, not a first time mom, but if you're a first time mom, you can read it too. But I'll have to let you know what I think of the whole thing when I am done with the whole book. But I've been reading this as well, started that about a couple weeks ago too, so in my second trimester. But I just think it's good to prepare, and I have been preparing for this labor as well. We did a Bradley Method course last child, and I've just been working on that again because I really want to stay relaxed and let my body do what it's supposed to do. So I've been doing a lot of relaxation and breathing techniques as well to help with that. Another thing I started doing probably right away in the second trimester, and then I backed off, is drinking my red raspberry leaf tea. I did do a little research, and this is a very controversial thing because some people say don't start till your third trimester and some people start right away second trimester. So I just picked it back up again about 2 weeks ago. When you're watching this, I'm about 23 and a half weeks along. So I picked it up at about 21 weeks along, and I just only have about 8 ounces a day, if that. I order the leaves from Amazon, so I'll link that for you too if you're interested. But I have been drinking that because it's supposed to help strengthen your uterus and just prepare all of that down there for birth. There's just different sides, and it's up to you to decide what you want to do. I did start drinking it at this point. I'm at 20 weeks. We did go in for our ultrasound to see the gender, and my husband and I don't ever do a big thing. We just go to the ultrasound and the doctor's appointment. Well, I have a nurse midwife appointment, and then we go out to eat together and open our little card of the gender. And so I am letting you know, nothing extravagant here. We are having another little girl, so it'll be really nice to have all the clothes. We have one room, so it'll be nice to just have that room more girl-oriented, and we're excited to have another little girl. So that'll be fun to have a little sister for Nevaeh and another little girl to run around with. But so that 20 weeks, we did that. And this little girl in the womb has been a lot different than Nevaeh, as I feel her move all the time at about 16 weeks. All over the place. And part of that is, my midwife said, my placenta is behind the baby, as with Nevaeh, our first daughter, the placenta was in the front, so it blocked a lot of that movement. So I can feel a lot of movement. And so all throughout the day, it's really fun. I get to feel this little girl move, and just what a special treat that is to have that feeling. So yeah, I'm about 23 and a half weeks along. If you want to see more pregnancy update videos, definitely give this video a like or comment below, because I can do more on those. One thing you can probably tell, I'm kind of, when I talk a lot, it's harder to breathe. I am carrying higher again. I thought I was carrying lower, but definitely still I'm carrying higher. Oh, and I have been starting to get my heartburn back again. With Nevaeh, I definitely got heartburn. And I can tell if I eat like red sauce in the evening or something spicier, I really get heartburn, and it's not fun to have that in the evening, and that's part of carrying a lot higher as well. But anyways, that is my pregnancy update on our little girl that we have coming end of May. So hope you enjoyed, and I will talk with you in my next video next week. Bye.